Hello and welcome to this video tutorial. Gareth here from tastytudes.com. In the introduction section of this course, we learned the concept of layers in Photoshop. We learned that in Photoshop, compositions are created and built using layers in the layers panel. This gives us the flexibility to move our creative elements around individually. This also gives us the ability to focus and treat layers as separate objects and apply to them separate effects. Now in Photoshop, we have a function called layer styles. Layer styles offer a range of visual effects that you can apply to layers within the layers panel. In this tutorial, I'm going to discuss the layer styles feature, and later I will demonstrate some examples which you can follow along with. Now the best way to learn is by watching and doing, so to help you, I have created this worksheet. To follow along with this, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this tutorial. Now if you have not already, you will also need to download and install the fonts so you will load them correctly into Photoshop to enable you to follow along. The worksheet and font instructions can be found in the Essential Practice folder in the Project folder. Now you can download this project folder for free, the download link is in the description. So with the project folder open, click Essential Practice, open the Layer Styles folder and you will find the instructions to install the fonts. Once you have installed the fonts, come back to the Layer Style folder, then open the Layer Styles PSD and you should have something that looks like this. So here on the left, we can see a variety of effects that can be created in Photoshop using Layer Styles. From the top, we have a drop shadow effect, a stroke effect, a gradient overlay effect, down on the left we have an outer glow effect, and next to this we have a color overlay effect. Now if we look over in the layers panel, inside the example area layer group folder, we can see all these different creative elements exist on their own separate layers. Now if we look closely at the layers in the layers panel, we can see something quite different that we have been used to thus far on the course. So we have the type icons and image thumbnails as normal, and the layer names, but now we have something else. Under the layer names, we seem to have additional information, and over on the right we have an FX icon. Well, this means that there are layer styles applied to that layer. So let's take a closer look at these examples on the left and see how layer styles work, and I'll start from the top. So the first example we have is a drop shadow. Now if I come over into the layers panel and focus on the drop shadow layer, we can tell by the symbol in the layers panel that this is a type layer, and it has a type symbol. So should I wish to press T to activate the type tool and click inside the type layer and edit like so, as I enter new type, you can see the effect being applied. Now if we look at the layer in the layers panel, we can see under the layer name that currently we have a drop shadow effect applied. So what I'm going to do now is place my mouse cursor over the right on top of the FX icon and double click. Upon double clicking, up will pop the layer styles properties box. To view the properties of the particular style applied to a particular layer, we can simply double click on the FX symbol on the layer. So to the left of this box is a list of all the possible layer styles we can apply to this layer. Currently, we can see here we have a tick on the drop shadow style. If I select this on the left, over on the right we can see the current properties of the drop shadow effect applied to my type layer. Now if I click repeatedly on and off the tick on the drop shadow layer style, notice the effect on the type toggling on and off in the canvas area. So I'll click OK and close the window. So I'll come to the next layer in the layers panel, stroke. So this time we can see a different layer style is applied. The effect applied to this layer is a stroke. So I'll place my mouse cursor over the right on top of the FX icon and double click. Upon double clicking, up will pop the layer style properties box again. Though this time we can see a tick inside the stroke style. If I click on the style on the left, we can see the properties of the stroke effect to the right. So I'll click OK again to close the window. So each of these creative elements below have a particular layer style applied, and we can clearly see what style is applied if we look closely in the layers panel. Now looking in the layers panel, we can see that next to the styles we have an eye symbol. Well, this represents the visibility of the effect. For example, if I want to turn the gradient effect off the type layer, I can simply click on the eye symbol to toggle it on and off. Notice the type is originally blue, but with the gradient effect applied, we have this pink to orange effect. So that's a couple of layer style examples. Let's now look at how we can create and apply layer styles. This is where you can follow along and have a go yourself. So I'm going to come into the Layers panel and toggle the Example Area Group folder up and toggle down the Exercise area. So in this Layer Group folder, we can see we have some layers without any styles applied. Here we have some type layers, an image layer, and a shape layer I have prepared earlier. So let's start at the top. So to this type layer, I want to apply a drop shadow. So first, we will need to select the layer in the Layers panel. With it selected, I'm going to move my mouse cursor just right of the name into the blank area, and now I'm going to double click. Upon double clicking, we will call up the Layer Style menu. So here is the menu we saw earlier. Now if we look over on the left, currently there is no layer style applied. So I want to apply a drop shadow to this layer. So I'll come across and click Drop Shadow. Upon click, we will apply a default shadow effect to the type layer. Now it's a case of coming over to the right and customizing the properties. So here you can see we have a range of options we can tweak. Now you can play around with these and experiment with various effects, but on this occasion I'm going to set my distance to 15. I can do this by clicking on the distance handle and dragging right or left like so. Now notice a little button on the top right called Preview. At this stage you will want to keep this checked, so you can see your preview effect on the layer as you customize your properties. So I'll click on the size and drag to 40. I'll click on the color and change this to blue. Then I'll click on the angle and move this a little and click OK. And now I have a drop shadow effect applied to the layer. If we look in the Layers panel, now we can see we have a FX icon and a drop shadow effect applied. Nice. So let's come back into the Layers panel, double click on the FX icon to open up the Layer Styles menu. If I think the drop shadow is looking a bit too much, I can toggle my properties. So I'll bring the distance down to 8 and the size down to 18 and perhaps change the opacity to 50%. Now you can apply more than just one layer style to a layer. For example, now I'll come over and click on the Bevel Emboss layer style. Now we will see a default effect applied, so I'll come over to the right and toggle the properties. So I'll change the technique to smooth, I'll change the depth to 400, the size to 7, and the soften to 6. Down on the opacity for the highlight, I'll change this to 59, and the opacity of the shadow to 6, and then I'll click OK. So now we have an interesting effect applied to the type layer. Now over in the Layers panel, we can see there is a bevel and emboss and a drop shadow effect applied to this layer. If I wish to toggle any of these effects on and off, I can do so by clicking on the eye symbol like so. Easy. So next, I'm going to apply a stroke to this stroke type layer. So just like earlier, I'll come and select the layer and double click in the space to the right of the layer name, and up will pop the layer style menu. So this time I'll click stroke. So I'm going to set the size to 13. Next I can toggle the position, but for now I'll leave it set to outside. If I want to toggle the opacity of this effect, I can do so, but for now I'll leave it set to 100%. I'll change the color to blue and click OK. So a simple stroke effect applied to that type layer. So next I want to apply a gradient overlay to the next type layer. So I'll come into the Layers panel, select the gradient type layer, and double click in the space next to the layer name on the right. Up will pop the Layer Styles menu, so I'll come over to the left and click on Gradient Overlay. Upon click, we will apply a default gradient of black and white. So over on the right, I can click on the gradient option and choose from a range of predefined gradients. If none of these gradients interest me, I can come to the bottom of the gradient editor here and click on some of the squares to add new color and toggle the gradient spread like so. Once the gradient color is applied, I can tweak the properties, like the angle, scale, and opacity. Once I'm happy, I'll click OK. So a very quick and easy gradient effect applied there. So next I have a shape layer. This arrow has been created using a custom shape, using the shape tool. Now layer styles can be applied to any layer, type, shape, or image. So on this custom shape here, I'm going to apply an outer glow. So I'll come over to the layers panel, select the layer and double click again. I'll choose outer glow from the layer styles menu on the left. Now on the right, I'll change the blending mode to normal. I'll click on the color and change to blue. I'll push the spread up to 8, the size up to 60, and perhaps change the opacity to 50%, and click OK. Pretty easy. So I'm going to apply the last layer style to an image layer, and I'm going to apply a color overlay. Now I find this one quite useful if I need to make a silhouette of a layer or shape I have in my composition. This works very well with cutout images with transparency around. So I'm going to select the red bird layer in the layers panel and double click on the space to the right of the name. On the left, I'll simply click color overlay, and now I have a color set on top of the whole layer, like so. Over on the right, I'll simply select a color. Let's go for a green here. You can also tweak the opacity of this effect, but for now I'll leave this set to 100% and I'll click OK. So that's how easy it can be to apply simple effects to your layers in Photoshop. Depending on your design, you may find some of these come in handy. Now there are a lot more styles that can be applied in Photoshop. These are just a few. Be sure to have a play around and explore the other styles and effects that can be applied using layer styles. Now over in the layers panel, towards the top, we have two layer options called Opacity and Fill. Now a lot of beginners and experienced practitioners of Photoshop often wonder what this is, as it's not commonly used. We learned in a previous episode that opacity works to fade a layer away to reveal the layers below. For example, let's come over to the stroke type layer we just applied a stroke to. With this layer selected, we can toggle the opacity up in the layers panel like so. Notice how I toggle the value down to 0, the entire layer begins to fade away. Now fill works slightly different. Watch what happens as I toggle the fill value down to 0% on the same layer. What is happening here is that the fill of the layer, the yellow type, is disappearing, much like it does with the opacity. But what has remained is the stroke, the layer style. So the opacity is for the entire layer, and the fill is for the contents of the layer and is not applied to the layer style. This can be useful if you want to create just an outline stroke of type with transparency inside. So I'll push the fill back up to 100%. For another example, I'll come down and select the shape layer with the outer glow applied. With the layer selected, I'll drag the fill down to 0%, and here we have an outer glow essentially applied to a transparent shape. So that's the difference between fill and opacity in the layers panel. It's a bit of a niche tool. You may not find yourself using it all that often, but it's there to be used. So in the next video, I'm going to discuss the pen tool and the concept of paths in Photoshop. I'll be briefly discussing some examples and then demonstrating how the tool works. So I'll see you in the next video.